What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. If you are here, chances are that you are trying to solve the maximum subarray problem and came across Kadane's algorithm but couldn't figure out how something like that is working. Or maybe you just want to learn a new concept which can make you better at programming and more prepared for interviews. Whatever the reason, you've come to the right place. So let's start by defining our problem. The maximum subarray problem is the task of finding the largest possible sum of a contiguous subarray within a given one-dimensional array of numbers. As an example for the array you see in front of you, the contiguous subarray with the largest sum is 2, 2, minus 1, 4 with sum 7. If you try to sum any other set of numbers, you won't get a result bigger than 7. Now, let's have a look at a very obvious solution to the given problem, and that's the brute force approach. Very obvious indeed, but not such a good solution, is to retrieve and calculate the sum of every possible subarray we can find in that array, and the maximum of those would be the solution. So in this example, we would have all of the following subarrays alongside their corresponding maximums. Let's call these local maximums. Then after we find every possible local maximum, we can find the maximum of these local maximums, and we would get the maximum sum possible. Let's call this result the global maximum. But notice that this is not a very good method, because as the size of the array increases, the number of possible subarray increases rapidly, thus increasing computational complexity. Or to be more precise, if the size of the array is n, then the time complexity of this solution is O of n to the power 3, which is really bad. And this can be clearly seen and deducted in the code you see in front of you, as this approach requires these nested loops to be implemented. Okay, some of you may say that this can be improved from O of n to the power 3 to O of n squared by simply using a variable to store the running sum of all the possible subarrays we have. But still, this approach is considered a brute force approach. You see, as long as we are working with a one-dimensional array, then there is somewhere hidden a linear time solution. If the input array was a 2D array, then yes, an n squared solution would have been great. But in our case, we have a 1D array, then there must be a linear time solution for this problem. So how can we improve this? Well, of course, Kadane's algorithm, the subject of today's video, is the answer. And to really understand it, we'll need the help of dynamic programming, which solves a complex problem by breaking it down into a collection of simpler sub-problems. If you want a detailed dive into dynamic programming, feel free to check the video linked in the card above before proceeding to the next section of this one. Now, how can we use dynamic programming to solve the problem at hand? What is the sub-problem we are trying to tackle here? Well, let's bring back the array we had as an example, and let's define the notion of local maximum at a certain index. What do we mean by this? Take index 3, all the possible subarrays that end with this index are shown in front of you. The sum of the elements stored inside each subarray is displayed to the right, and the maximum number between these sums is the local maximum at index 3. Now, suppose we manage to find all the local maximums at each index, then we'd have gone through all the possible subarrays available. And the maximum of these local maximums will be our global maximum, or in other terms, our result. But how is this going to reduce the complexity of our algorithm down from O of n squared? Well, we should find the subproblem and figure out how we can solve the next subproblem using the results of the previous one. So what's our subproblem here? If you take a closer look, you will notice that the subarrays at index 4 are similar to the subarrays at index 3, with the addition of the value at index 4. So, to deduce the subarrays at index 4, all we have to do is add the current index value to them one by one. But mathematically speaking, if we have 10 numbers and we add the same number to all of these numbers, then the number that was the maximum will remain the maximum, right? And if we extend this logic to the array at hand by excluding the first subarray, which is the new value considered alone, you will notice that in the end we are adding to the sum of these subarrays the same values, hence the maximum between these subarrays will remain the same, no matter the value we added. Therefore, to check the local maximum at index 4, all we need to do is take the maximum between the two subarrays highlighted in red. Because if that subarray led to the local maximum at index 3, then whatever we add to it, it will remain the maximum among these two subarrays. The only one we need to additionally take into consideration is the value stored in the first subarray alone. And this leads us to the principle on which Kadane's algorithm works. The local maximum at index I is the maximum between the value stored at index I and the sum of that value to the local maximum at index I minus 1 previously calculated. By using this methodology, all we have to do is traverse the array just once to get these values, and then the maximum among all these values will represent the global maximum. This way, at every index I, the problem boils down to finding the maximum between two numbers. Thus, the maximum subarray problem can be solved by solving these subproblems of finding local maximums. Also note that the local maximum at index 0 would be the value stored at index 0 itself, as we have a single subarray. So, as a recap, Kadane's algorithm uses optimal substructures, hence can be viewed as a simple example of dynamic programming. And by using the thought process we just saw, all we need to do is iterate through the array just once, allowing us to find the maximum sum of a contiguous subarray in an O of n time complexity. Let's go ahead now and see what this would look like in code. In the maxSubarray method, we are first going to initialize the local and global maximum variables. Then, as mentioned, we will need to iterate only once on the elements stored inside the given array, and for each iteration, we are going to find the maximum between the current value we are at and the sum of that value added to the previous local maximum we retrieved. The maximum of these local maximums we fetched will be the global maximum we want. This value was retrieved again with the help of the math.max method. Finally, after the iteration is done, we return with the global maximum, which is the solution to our maximum subarray problem. I will have the LeetCode problem link for this video in the description below. Feel free to play around with it and test the code against multiple pre-written test cases as you see fit. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.